Hello, everybody, and welcome to this week's It's Tuesday, It's Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English with me, your host, it's Roy. Hello, everybody, and welcome. Do let me know. Now, about an hour ago, we sent out a request for words that you would like me to pronounce in this week's Pronunciation Live. So thank you to all of the people who sent me words from across the world that you would like me to pronounce. But if you didn't manage to send me a word, don't worry, as you can keep sending words throughout today's show. So just keep sending them and I will pronounce as many words as I possibly can. And do remember to say hello and share and like this post. Now, let me tell you a couple of things very briefly about this performance, about this show today, this lesson. First of all, it's called Pronunciation Live. So this show is more about pronunciation. I may explain briefly some of the meanings of the words, but it is very focused on pronunciation. Second of all, make sure that you can hear me, okay? So maybe don't have me blasting out very loud if you're in a library. Put in some earphones or put on some headphones. And finally, my name is Roy, and I am from the south of England. I live on a place called the Isle of Wight. I was born in the north, but I moved south. So this is my accent. My accent is quite southern. Why am I telling you this? Well, because across the United Kingdom, there are many different accents. And even in the BBC Learning English team, you're gonna hear lots of different accents, and that's fine. But this is mine. And I will be saying it with my voice. So before we get started, I have a little quiz for you today, a little test. And that is this. Today's challenge is, which of these words has the most syllables? Which of these words has the most syllables? I'm not gonna say the words, but that's today's challenge. And you will find out at the end of this pronunciation live class, what is the answer. But start thinking, what could be the word with the most syllables? I'm getting lots of hellos. I saw Chris says, hello from Sydney. Hello, Chris. Sarah says, hello from Syria. Hello. Lots of people from all over, keep saying hello, keep making sure to say hello. Kabib, sorry if I got your name wrong, but hello to Pakistan, hello. I can't read your name, but hello to you in Ukraine. Hello from the Isle of Wight in the south of England. And Kit Kat says hello from the Philippines. Hello from the Isle of Wight in the south of England. Okay, without further ado, let's crack on with some of the words that you sent me today. So this first word comes from manisco, and it is parlour. Parlour. So parlour. So that second syllable is the schwa sound. L, It's a very weak sound. Now, this schwa sound, we call it the schwa. I like that word, schwa. But it's basically a sound. So imagine when you are as old as me and you sit down, you go, oh, it's like that kind of sound. And it is a weak sound. We have it in things like water, water, parlor, center, So this is a weak sound. Manisco, thank you very much for the word parlor. Let's see to our next one. So this one comes from Bijou. And the first word is sate. Sate. The second word is grove, and the third word is lament. Now that first word, sate, is a verb, and it means to satisfy your appetite. The reason I want to say about this is because this probably isn't the most, people don't normally say, I'm going to sate my appetite. It's not a commonly used word. I wouldn't go to the restaurant and say, I need to sate my appetite. But it exists, it's a good word to know. A good word to pronounce. Probably more naturally, we would say satisfy, or just, you know, eat something nice, you know, satisfy my hunger. But thank you very much for Bijou to sate Rove and Lament. Brilliant. Thank you very much for that. And remember to keep sending me words. I will dip into the comments right after this one from Aya. Aya wants to know the names of the planets in our solar system. So we have Mercury, 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 three syllables, Mercury. We have Venus, two syllables, Venus, Mars, Mars. We have Jupiter, Jupiter, Saturn, Saturn, Uranus, Uranus, and Neptune, Neptune. Now, I very quickly want to talk about that Neptune. Quite commonly, not always, but quite commonly, as I can think of, that T-U in English is commonly pronounced as chu, like the tube. The tube in London is the name for the underground. Tuna, tuna sandwich, the fish, tuna. So commonly we say ch for that sound, Neptune. So it's Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Of course, missing from that list is where we live, which is Earth. Earth, that TH sound that I will be going into more a little bit later on in this pronunciation live. Earth. And of course, if you really want to get technical, I think Pluto, which is at the far end of our solar system, isn't a planet. It's classed as a dwarf planet, I think. This is a pronunciation class for English, not a science class or a physics class, but I hope I'm correct. But thank you very much, Aya, for those words. And now let's dip into the comments. Okay. Wine wants to know nostalgia. 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 You're going to ruin that one. Bice, I can see Bice has got a word for me. I've already got it to come up today. Let's do it very quickly now. It is, Bice, it is Colonel. 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 It looks like Colonel, but this is pronounced. Helps if I can pronounce on a pronunciation class, right? But this is pronounced Colonel. It is a rank in the military. So you have like sergeants, majors, lieutenants, and colonel. Colonel. So it's got this colonel sound. Very good. Eric wants to know breach and breach. Similar pronunciation for those. Emily wants to know bottom and button. Bottom, button. Bottom, button. So your bottom is the base of something, the bottom of your bag. Bottom. And the second word is button. 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 Brilliant. Thank you very much for that, Emily. And keep sending me your words and keep saying hello. Yep. Veronica, I just said this word. It is lieutenant. Lieutenant. Now, this is a weird one because it looks like lieutenant. It looks like lieutenant. But of course, in American English, they say lieutenant. In British English, we say lieutenant. It's got a sound in there. I don't know why. We just say lieutenant. But yeah, in the movies, in the films, you're going to hear a lot of lieutenant because a lot more films come from America. So you'll hear this. But lieutenant is British English. Thank you very much for sending me that word. And if you're joining me now, welcome. This is BBC Learning English Pronunciation Live. With me, it's your host, it's Roy. And welcome on this wonderful Tuesday. And remember, today we have a little quiz about which of these words has the most syllables. Is it A, B, C, D, E, or F? Now, remember that we are all over social media. We here at BBC Learning English are all over social media. We're on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and Twitter. So we're everywhere on social media. Probably right now, you're either watching me on Facebook or you're watching me on YouTube. Notice again that TU has that tube sound, chew sound for me that I talked about earlier. YouTube. So make sure to follow us. And of course, I will tell you the answer to this quiz a little bit later on in today's class. Brilliant. There we go. So let's go back and move on to our next word. So this one is from Ezra. And Ezra would like to know disassemble, habitually. So again, that's got that ch sound there, habitually. Casualty, and bimetallic strip. So you've got disassemble, habitually, casualty, and bimetallic strip. Thank you, Ezra, very much for that word. And moving on, we have Bijou, and Bijou would like to know periwinkle, primrose, tufts, reclined, twigs. Now, probably tufts is quite a difficult word to say. Tufts. Okay. Now, my wife is from Brazil, and I learned Portuguese when I lived out there. The reason I'm telling you this is sometimes some sounds, some words are very, very complicated or very difficult to say because our mouths aren't used to making these sounds. And it's kind of like going to the gym. The best way I describe it, you need to train the muscles in your mouth to make these sounds. I'm going to talk about it again with the TH sound a little bit later on. So if you have a problem saying one of these sounds, probably the best thing to do is stand in front of a mirror. Just kind of practice. I know it sounds a bit strange having a conversation with yourself, but also throughout this class, make sure that you're saying the words that I say as well. So when I say tufts, try and say it as well. Tufts. And if it's difficult, slow it down. Tufts. Tufts. Sometimes it's better to be understood speaking slowly than it is to speed it up, because sometimes when we're scared of pronunciation, we say things as quickly as possible. Tufts of grass. It's not the best way. Slow it down. Tufts. So thank you very much for those very interesting words, Bijou. And a popular member always at the show is Evgeny. Hello, Evgeny. Evgeny would like to know, there'll be, there's been. Okay, so let's look at there's. So it's there's. It's a z sound at the end of that. There's. There's a window there. There'll be. There'll be. There'll be. There'll be. And finally, there's been. Now, sometimes we pronounce that been. Sometimes when it's as a kind of auxiliary, when it's a verb in sense, sometimes we cut it to a bin sound. That's the best way I can say. There's been an accident. There's been an accident. So when the emphasis maybe isn't too strongly on that word, we cut it to bin. Bin. There's been. So there's, there'll be, and there's been. Thank you, Evgeny, for sending that word over to me today. Brilliant word, as per usual. And if you're joining me now, this is BBC Learning English with me, your host. It's Roy. We're here live on the Tuesday from the Isle of Wight, which is in the south. Looks a little bit like that, near to my house. True story, except for the dog. So we're from the Isle of Wight. And if you're joining me now, thank you very much. Keep sending your words throughout today. I saw a very interesting word there. I'd like to... keep sending your words so I can pronounce them for you. This is the meaning of this class. This is the reason we're all here, to help you learn some pronunciation. Eric would like to know that word. Now, that's usually how we abbreviate it. I would probably pronounce that as department. So you'd have the fire depths, but I would say fire department. So I would personally still read that as department. Very good. Thank you, Eric. Maria, hello to you in Italy from England. Hello. Not your girl wants to know handkerchief. 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 So it's kind of like that D is very silent. It's not handkerchief. It's handkerchief. Handkerchief. Thank you very much. Not your girl. Ang Pien says, hi, teacher. Hi, student. Hello. Tai. I'm going to go with Tai. Hopefully I got that right. Says, hi from Myanmar. Hello. Hello from here. Samira wants to know tests and nests. So we have tests and nests. Tests, nests. Thank you, Samira. Thank you very much for that. You're going so quick. These comments are going up. Loda, hello again. Wants to know mentor and monitor. So sometimes it can be about mentor somebody, but mentor is the common pronunciation here. She's my mentor. Or he's my mentor. Taught me everything I know. Rob, a good friend of mine, he's commonly known as my mentor. He taught me a lot of things. And monitor means to watch something, to monitor something. Thank you, Loda, for that word. Federica wants to know, horrible word, sewage. Federica wants to know sewage. Sewage is, of course, all the polluted kind of waste that comes out of things like houses, your toilets, down into the sewers. There are sewage. Horrible word, smelly word, but a great pronunciation to learn. Sewage. 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 Very, very good. Ozzy saying, I'm here from Indonesia. Hello. Here from the Isle of Wight. Catherine wants to know, encourage, encourage, encourage. I encourage you to keep sending words. Keep sending words. Brilliant. Ah, it goes so fast. Amit wants to know, major and minor. Major and minor. Thank you very much for that word. And Rita says, hello from Egypt. Hello. Hello to you. It's a country I'd love to visit. I'd love to see the Sphinx and the pyramids. It'd be brilliant. Sahib wants to know schedule. Schedule. Your schedule is your timetable. Some people will pronounce this schedule. I personally say schedule. But you can say it either way. Either way. Very good. And hi, I'm Mike from Mexico City. Hi, Mike. How are you doing? Hello to you. I keep seeing people asking me how I am. I'm very well, thank you. I'm doing very, very well. But I'm going to take a drink right now because that's important. I just sing that one. Huda, come back to me. There we go. Huda Huda wants to know, can we pronounce T-U as chew? Chew, like the tube. Tube. It's something I was talking about earlier. Tube. If that, I hope that answers your question. Tube. Habitually. Trying to think of other words. These are coming so quickly. Hello, Ismet from Bangladesh. Hello to Bangladesh. Hello to you. And Nagoyan wants to know, how do you pronounce? It's a classic. Classic word, Worcestershire. It looks like Worcestershire. It looks like a massive word. But this is Worcestershire. Worcestershire. Break it down. Worcestershire sauce. If it gets a bit, sometimes we call it tongue-tied when we get a bit tongue-tied. This is an expression sometimes. So we say, if you find you're saying like Worcestershire sauce and you're struggling, sometimes I do. I say, oh, could you pass me the Worcestershire sauce? And I kind of get a bit, break it down, slow it down. There's nothing wrong with slowing it down a little bit to be understood. So I'll say, excuse me, could you pass me the Worcestershire sauce? Just to slow it down. Avoids getting tongue-tied. It's a good tip from me. That's how I survive. Hemant wants to know, southern and northern. Southern and northern. Southern and northern. Southern and northern. And Akash says, I'm a huge fan. Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello. thank you for all those words so far. And if you're joining me now, My name is Roy. This is BBC Learning English Pronunciation Live. We're live on a Tuesday, which is always a good day. Every day's a good day. And keep sending me words, because about an hour ago, a bunch of you sent me some words, and they were brilliant. But of course, all through the this lesson, keep sending me words. And just to let you know, we have a website. Hopefully you've been there. It's www.bbclearningenglish.com. And the reason I'm telling you about that, there's lots of free kind of learning materials to help you learn English all over the website. There's new stuff being updated all the time, all these lessons. So do check it out, bbclearningenglish.com. And of course, as well, brave new world, we're moving into the world of technology. We've got an app. We have an app. So if you've got a phone, like you want it on your phone, make sure you go to either the Google Play Store or the App Store on your Apple phone, your iPhone, and download the app. BBC Learning English, search for that. And it's a free app, which of course for me is the best price. Now, remember at the start, I asked you this quiz, which of these words has the most syllables? You're going to be finding out in 9 minutes' time. But before that, I just want to talk through a few more words that I got sent. So remember, which of these words has the most syllables? A, B, C, D, E, or F? Brilliant. Make sure you send me that. Okay, so let's move on to some of the other words. Zauro, hopefully they said your name correctly, wants to know thought, taught, and fought. Thought is the past of think, taught is the past of teach, and fought is the past of fight. So all of these three words have the ought sound. Thought, taught, and fought. Thought, taught, and fought. The difference comes at the start. So you've got th, t, and f. Thought, taught, and fought. Now, I'm going to focus in on that th sound. This is a common question that students ask, how to say the th sound. Well, commonly, there's a few different pronunciations of the TH sound, but commonly the big two are th and th. So thought and though. So if you remove the T at the end, it becomes though. Now, thought is a kind of an unvoiced sound. It's thought, thought. Though has this vibration in our necks. So to make the th sound, we put our tongues on our teeth and kind of blow like you're blowing a candle. Are you trying to? I know it's strange, but thought, thought. The air comes, thought, thought. And we take our tongues off gradually at the end. The sound is more kind of vibrations here. And we do that by my tongue is kind of. If I hold it, it makes a weird noise. So the, and it's kind of like you're trying to imitate a bee or a wasp, like the best way, as I said before, is to keep practicing. I know those words are a little bit, those sounds can be a little bit tricky for some speakers who've never had to pronounce them in their language. Best thing to do is practice, 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 like you're going to the gym. The first time, it's not very comfortable. First time you go to the gym, more you train, the easier it gets. So thought and though. So these three words, though, thanks to Zauro, are thought, taught, and fought. Thank you very much for sending those words. William wants to know thorough and thoroughly. Thorough. And thoroughly, thorough, thorough, two syllables, thoroughly, three syllables, thorough, thoroughly, thorough, thoroughly. Thank you very much for that one. Melinda sent me a message saying bought, brought, and but. She gets confused between the sounds of bought, brought, and but. So you've got bought, ought, bought, brought. Bought is the past of buy, brought is the past of bring. So bought, so you've got that ought sound with a b, bought. You've got the brought, brought, and you've got but. But is it so you've got this or sound, a long sound, but. And sometimes the way we say it, the sounds doesn't, the T's not even very well pronounced, but I didn't want to go, but I didn't want to go, but I didn't want to go. But. There's nothing wrong with saying it if you want to say it, but I say it sometimes, but I say it like that. But the way I'm speaking at the moment is actually my normal speaking sound. So Stella wanted to know bruise. So when you hurt yourself and you get that mark on your arm and it's like bruise. It's a long sound. Bruise. Very good. Thank you very much. I can hear my son in the background. If you hear my son right now, he's singing a beautiful song. I don't know what he's singing, but it sounds very nice. So apologies if you can hear that in the background. But bruise is from Stella. Thank you very much. Let's dip now into the comments. Arsang wants to know mountain. Hope that helps. Laura wants to go a common one. Squirrel. There are quite a few videos on YouTube and all over the place with people trying to pronounce this word, having difficulties with this word. It's squirrel. Squirrel. Sometimes best to break it down rather than say squirrel. 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 Slow it down. No problem in slowing it down to practice. Sahib says, thank you from Iraq. Well, thank you for joining us from England. Thank you for joining us. Ali wants to know 8 and 8. Okay, sometimes these words have a similar pronunciation, like I ate it yesterday, the past of eat. Sometimes I'm quite lazy on this sound. A number of people are. Some people say et for 8. So the first word can be pronounced 8 or et. I ate it yesterday. I ate it yesterday. So sometimes it has the same pronunciation. Sometimes it's pronounced as et. I'm quite lazy on that one. And, oh, it's a good word. Diana wants to know, colloquialism. It means something from a region or an area, like a piece of language, a colloquialism. Where I'm from on the Isle of Wight, we have some colloquialisms, some expressions that are from here. Ang wants to know bad, bat, bet. No, he doesn't. No, you don't. Sorry. Bad is B-A-D. Bat is like the creature or the bat. Bed is where I sleep, and I will be going to very shortly. I'm joking. No, not soon enough. And bet. Bad, bat, bed, and bet. Hope that helps. Thank you very much for that. Keep sending the words very quickly. We've got a few minutes left. Mins wants to know quiet and quite. Quiet, two syllables. Quite, that is one. Diana wants to know floxynoxy nihilipification. It's not a commonly used word, Diana, but that's floxynoxy nihilipification. A lot of people send that to kind of trick us up. It's not really a word that is very used. Saraj Shit says hello. Hello to you. Keep sending in words. Hannah wants to know vocabulary. Vocabulary. Sometimes we just say vocab. It's quicker. Najenda wants to know jest and jester. Jest and jester. And I have a couple more words very quickly. I have one more word from Abdul. Abdul wants to know congratulations. Again with that chew sound. Congratulations. So hopefully I'm going to be saying congratulations in a minute. Remember, there are live classes across the week on YouTube and Facebook. tomorrow is Wednesday, so there'll be a grammar class. I believe it's with Beth, but I think. But check it out. Remember, same time, same place, 1:30. We are live. But at the start of today's class, I asked you, which of these words has the most syllables? Tell me the answers now. Start them flooding in. Is it, oh, we've got some answers. I can see some answers. Alessandra says B. Jasmine says hello. Ezra says B. Eric says A. Leigh says B. Alette says, Melode says B. Asim says F. Manuel says A. This is going so fast. Cloudy's gone for a range. B, C, D, and F. Okay. And Myra says C. And 10K Challenge says A. Well, the answer, ladies and gentlemen, is B. The word with the most syllables is B. And let me tell you why. So that first word, A, is a place. It's a city not far from where I was born. And it's called Leicester. 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 Two syllables. B has the most syllables. It has four. Society. Society. So you got Leicester, society. I was going to say number three. C is ambition. Three syllables. Ambition. D is article. Article. Three syllables. E is barrier. Three syllables. Barrier. And F is classify. Classify. So Leicester, society, ambition, article, barrier, classify. Well done if you said B. If you said B, maybe next time I need to take it up a level and make it more difficult. But yes, well done. And somebody here says, I can't read your name. I apologize. But yay, I was wrong. But I've learned something new. That is the right spirit to have there. That is absolutely the right way to feel about it. Wim very quickly wants to know, sorry, syllables and synonym. Syllables, sorry, syllables and synonym. Hopefully you wanted all three of those words and you weren't apologizing. There is never any need to apologize if you were for asking for pronunciation. Sarah says, I got it. Yes, well done. Jessica says, have a great day. Yes, have a great day to you all. Estefania says, thanks. There's lots of byes coming up. Bye. Okay, guys, that leads me to today to say thank you very much for watching. This was BBC Learning English Pronunciation Live with me, your host, on a Tuesday. It was Roy. Make sure to join us for the next lives. We're all across the week. Thank you very much for your time. And it is good to be back pronouncing on Pronunciation Live. Take care and have a great day. Bye.